Hello, Team 201. We're busy looking at the conceptual framework, and our next stop on this journey is having a look at the reporting entity and financial statements. So far, we've looked at what the framework is driving us to do, and that's providing useful information to users of financial information that's presented in financial statements. And to make that information useful, we want to make sure that that information has got a certain quality, a high quality to that information, which the qualitative characteristics that we've discussed will hopefully help you in achieving. Now, the one assumption we've made so far is two words. It's financial statements and also the reporting entity. Who is this company's users? Who is this company? What is this company? What makes it up? And the other assumption then is the financial information and financial statements. So your conceptual framework provides you some guidance with this. The first one that I want to consider is the easier one, perhaps, and that's the financial statements, which just give you a report on your assets, your liabilities, equity, income, and expenses. I want to spend a moment longer, though, on looking at the thing that we refer to as a reporting entity. To date in your studies, you might have had very simplistic examples of sole traders, perhaps small private companies that are a legal entity. And because they're a legal entity, we've tended to also consider them as a separate entity for financial reporting. And because they have to give reports to the tax man, we focused on doing financial reports for that legal entity. But conceptually, just because the lawyers tell us that that business is a business, they can structure things in many different ways. You could, for example, have a business and want to keep the manufacturing side separate from the retail side. Perhaps there's too much risk in the manufacturing plant, and you don't want to have both components of your business going under in tough times, for example. It's just a hypothetical case. So you might approach your lawyer and you say, you know what, we're one entity at the moment with this manufacturing and retail. I'd like you to split that into two separate companies. So we'd have the manufacturing company and the retail company. And then they could be controlled by an admin company on top. So what you need to do as an accountant, and this is a concept that's going to come through more and more during your studies, is you've got to look at the substance of what's going on here. What is really happening here? Do we have three entities, the admin, the manufacturing, and the retail division? Or do we actually only have one company with just separate parts in it? So you've got to have a look at who the users of the reports are. Who's the owners of these companies? Because if the owners of those three companies are the same, it's all reporting to one central person or persons. In substance, you've got one bubble around these three companies. So in substance, we have one reporting entity. You may need to still, for legal reasons, prepare financial statements for the manufacturing, the retail, and the admin to give to the South African Revenue Services. But when we're trying to report to society about this entity's operations, we want to report about the whole entity. There's one owner. He's legally split it to protect himself in liquidation. But he did that to change the legal form, not the substance. He still has one business. And it's that one business that we want to provide financial reports on. So you'll already be thinking, yes, that's sounding some familiar. It's consolidated financial statements. And we will go into more depth quite early on in the year into that section of financial accounting. But just for now, I want you to focus on this, the part of the framework that sort of is a basis for us to work from when we get to consolidations. You want to report on the substance of the entity. Is there one entity? And as you go along in your studies, you're going to get many more complex examples. This is the Disney companies. On the right-hand side of your screen in the Mickey Mouse picture is all those little circles represent separate legal entities. And I've then zoomed in on the one ear on the one side just to show you the Marvel components. So if you had to be the CFO of the Disney companies, you'd need to sit back and decide, where am I going to do financial reporting? Is it going to be in each and every one of those little bubbles? But if all those bubbles have the same shareholders, surely the shareholders might be more interested in the collective picture of the company as a whole? That may be the case, I'm not sure exactly the legal structuring and who the shareholders of all these, but if you're assuming that every one of these companies comes back to common shareholders, then you might be having a spreadsheet for your consolidation purposes with each one of these circles being added into it. So if we come back to our summary of what we've been doing, you're preparing financial information in the form of financial statements for users of that financial information that needs to be useful to them in making their decisions. And now we've got to consider exactly who is that entity. You can't just assume that it's a legal entity. And once we've decided who that entity is that we're reporting on, now we can start writing on this piece of paper and, for example, say, this is the General Journal of Rookie Limited and for what period we're reporting.